In this video, I'm going to show you how to create and share a StreamNet application without installing anything. This can be super helpful if you're at work and you aren't allowed to install Python, but you still want to develop and also use a StreamNet application. Or maybe you just need a quick and easy way to share your StreamNet application with others without having to deploy it. To do this, we are using a platform called PyCafe. And without further ado, let us dive in. First, sign up and create a free account on PyCafe. Once that is done, create a new StreamNet project. Here you can start building your StreamNet application. On the left, you will see the file directory, where you can create folders and files. In the center, there's a text editor for writing code. And on the right, you will see your StreamNet application running in real time. Now, here's the cool part. This StreamNet application is running in your browser using WebAssembly. It is not deployed on any server. That means you can develop your application entirely online, share a link with others, and that's it. Let me show you an example. If I make a change to my code and press Ctrl and S to save it, the app instantly detects the update. Now, when I refresh a page, you will see that the changes are reflected right away. Also, PyCafe runs an unmodified version of StreamNet. That means all the features you are familiar with, like sliders, charts, data frames, and much more, they are all fully supported here. Now, let's say you've already shared your application with others and you want to make some updates. Updating your app is actually pretty simple here. All you need to do is to click the Publish button, and any changes you made will be instantly become visible to your users. And speaking of sharing your application, let me show you the different options you have. The first option is to share your entire project. To demonstrate this, I will copy this link to my clipboard and open it in a new browser window. Now, before we move on, I want to mention something you will notice when using PyCafe. It can take a little time for your app to load. That's because your application isn't being served from a traditional server. It's being executed directly in your browser. So, for the sake of time, I'm going to speed up the video for the next few examples so that you don't have to sit through the loading process. Alright, and with that said, here is what it looks like when someone opens the link. They will basically see the same interface as you, so the editor mode. This means they can view, edit, and even play around with your code by adding or deleting files. However, any changes they make won't be saved to your project. When they refresh the link, everything will be reset to your original version. Alright, next up, you can also just share the application itself. Now, if you look closely at the link, you will notice it is almost the same as the project link. The only difference is that the word app is included in the URL. And also here, let me show you how it looks like. So I will copy the link, open it in a new browser window, and once the app loads, here is what we get. You will see your normal StreamNet application, but with a PyCafe banner at the top. And if someone clicks on the editor button in the banner, it will bring them back to the edit view we looked earlier. Alright, and lastly, let's talk about another option, which is embedding your application. And I think this is also a really interesting feature. So if you have already a website, you can embed your StreamNet application using an HTML iframe. Instead of showing a banner at the top, PyCafe will add a footer to your application. The footer includes a link that you can configure to open either the app itself or the full project view. Plus, you can also customize the footer's theme to match your style. So also here, let me show you how it works. So first, I will copy the embed code snippet to my clipboard. In my case, I will embed the application into my WordPress site. To do this, I will add an HTML element, drag it onto my page, and paste the code in here. The only thing I'm going to change here is the height. Instead of the default 400 pixels, I will increase it to 800 pixels. Once that's done, I will save the changes and open the site in a new window. Alright, and here we go. Once the app loads, this is what it looks like. At the bottom, you can see the footer with the different links, and the app itself works just like it should be. For example, if I adjust the slider, the chart below updates accordingly. Now, embedding a StreamNet application into WordPress is just one example though. You can embed it in pretty much any website. For instance, here's another example, embedding it into a Notion notebook. Inside my Notion workspace, I will create a new page and add an embed element. Instead of using an iframe this time, I will simply grab the app link from PyCafe. So let me copy the link, head back to Notion, and paste it into the box here. Alright, and that's it. Now you have embedded a StreamNet application right inside a Notion page. And of course, if you want, you can also publish your Notion page. Just click on Share, then enable the Publish option, and hit the button to make it live. Now, when I visit my public page, you will see my Notion page with my StreamNet application included, fully functional and ready to use. Alright, and just a quick note here. Embedding a StreamNet application into existing pages isn't exactly a new feature. For example, if you have deployed your app to the StreamNet Community Cloud, you can also embed those apps using an iframe or OEmbed. You will find more details on how to do this in the StreamNet documentation. I will leave a link to that page in the description box below. So I just want to point out that embedding is not specific to PyCafe. Alright, and with that said, let's now switch over to the PyCafe documentation and talk about some important considerations. As mentioned earlier, PyCafe uses WebAssembly and PyUdite to run your StreamNet application directly in your browser. While this is super convenient, it does come with some limitations. For instance, there is no support for threading, you can't access your local file system, and not all the Python packages are supported. That said, many popular Python packages do work. Basically, if a package is supported by PyUdite, it will also work in PyCafe too. And you can find a list of all the supported packages by following the link provided in the documentation here, or simply testing it out on PyCafe. Next, let's also talk about some advantages listed here. The biggest one, of course, is that you don't need to install anything, set up any infrastructure, or worry about deployment. You just develop your app right in the browser and share it directly with others. Plus, since the app runs in your browser and not on a server, it can scale to an infinite number of users without any extra effort. That said, there are also a few more considerations you should keep in mind. Since your code runs in the browser, your source code is sent to the user and can be directly viewed. This, of course, means you should avoid including sensitive information like API keys or database passwords in your code. And you also can't use environment variables to hide your secrets, as there is no server involved. However, PyCafe does provide a way for users to bring their own access key. For example, if you are building an AI application, users could enter their own OpenAI API keys instead of you embedding one in the code. And you can find more details on how it works here in the documentation. Another important point to mention is about the database credentials. So, as I just mentioned, you should avoid including your database credentials in your application. However, if you use a service like Superbase, you can set up row-level security with read-only access. In that case, it is safer to include credentials because you've restricted access to your data directly in Superbase. Alright, and lastly, let's touch on pricing. With a free PyCafe account, you can create and share as many public applications as you want. The only limitation right now is on file hosting. In the future, they also plan to introduce a pro plan, which will allow you to create and share private projects. However, there is no additional information about this plan at the moment. Alright guys, and that is all I have for you today. Let me know in the comments what you think about PyCafe and if you have a use case for it. As always, thanks for watching and I will see you in the next video.